One of our community members by the name of Quinn Williams asked me, "Hey Daniel, is it possible to walk through text in Filmora 9? This one goes out to you, Quinn. Stick around, I'll show you how. Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation. This video is sponsored by the good people at Filmora. The trick to pulling off this effect is understanding the mask features in Filmora 9. You might remember a couple of weeks ago, I used these features to turn myself into a piece of fruit. Today's effect isn't much different. The only thing you have to know going in is that Filmora doesn't allow you to add masking tracks directly into a titles or text track. So you'll need to create whatever text you want to use and bounce that footage. Now, bouncing is a term that I use for exporting whatever's in your timeline at a very high resolution and bitrate, and then bringing that exported footage back into Filmora to use again. That footage will always end up with a color in the background, which by default is black, but I'm gonna throw green in the background behind this text. I've added a little dissolve to it, and I don't want any shades of gray to inadvertently be removed later on. Now your text track has been converted to a video track, and masks can be applied. Lay your text track in a track above your main footage. Use the chroma key feature in the upper left to remove the background, and now your text track will allow the main track below it to show through. In the upper left under the Effects tab, choose Utilities, and you'll find your mask feature. We're going to stack multiple masks onto this track because one won't be enough for what I'm trying to accomplish. I'll bring down three and see where that gets me. I can always add more masks later. As I've shown you in other videos, you can choose many different mask shapes as well as control the height, width, size, and placement of that mask. You can also control the edge feathering and the inversion of it. Inversion just controls whether the track below it will show through the inside of the shape we've created or the outside of that shape. For our purposes today, we want to invert our mask, which will allow us to erase the text wherever we place the mask. Now, the next steps many of you have seen me do a lot of times. Wherever I think my mask needs to begin, I simply split my footage in the timeline at that point and begin activating the masks by clicking on that section in my timeline, going up to the video tab in the upper left, and at the very bottom, I'll find each of those mask controls under the video effects menu. I can see all three masks I've added right here, but I'll only activate the top one for now and start placing it where I want for this frame in the video sequence. This is actually a pretty tricky piece of footage because it's filmed so low that there isn't just one body part moving through the text. It's two separate legs and feet walking through at different times. So I've definitely given myself a challenge here today. The right leg and foot goes through first, so let's bring the mask over and modify the shape and size of it to see if I can erase or mask out that area of text that would be hidden by this person walking in front of it. There are no hard and fast rules here. I'm just trying to use whichever shapes, sizes, and edge feathering seem to do a decent job of erasing the text I don't want to see. Once I have that frame looking pretty decent, I move the playhead forward one frame in my timeline. Make sure you have your timeline stretched all the way out so that when you move forward, you're only moving forward a single frame at a time. Move one frame forward, slice your text track to separate that frame, and now you can manually move the mask to make any minor adjustments needed as this person begins to walk forward. I'll keep adjusting this mask, moving forward one frame at a time in my timeline and slicing the footage to separate each frame, which will allow me to change the mask in the next frame without moving the mask in the previous frame. As the second foot comes into screen, I'll need to activate the other masks as well. This will allow me to drop multiple smaller masks within my track and erase a lot of different areas at once. Use your judgment here with whatever footage you've decided to create. Just keep slicing your footage and moving your masks to get something which seems to work. I'm going to keep this one fairly simple and just use these three masks. Now, there will come a point where you want the body to move through the text, so here's where you'll have to use your imagination a bit. Just like the way a body moves through water, the text should separate completely as the body moves through it and close back up slowly behind it as it passes through. So I'll just start watching the motion of these legs and feet and start shrinking the width of the mask as they move through to create the illusion of that text closing back up behind the legs and feet as they get to the other side of this text. Again, all of this is completely arbitrary depending on where you decide that person should be passing through this text. Try to look at where you think the text seems to be positioned as compared to the main footage, and use that as a reference point in your mind. To me, the text looks like it's lined up with this spot on the ground. So when this person reaches that point, that's where I'll begin the passing through masking technique. Feel free to run your footage while you're working so that you can go back and make any minor adjustments where things might be looking a little janky. Once your person is passed all the way through, you can turn off the masks for the rest of the footage, and you should end up with something that looks like this. If you want to learn more Filmora tips, tricks, and techniques, be sure to click on the video on screen now or the ones I'll link down below. Peace.